Troop 142 is a story set at a Boy Scout camp. Boy Scouts, I don't know if they exist in France in the same way. It's a little different from what I've heard, but in America and in England, I'm from England, the Boy Scouts is something that kids do until they're about 18 years old. They go to, and frequently, especially in the area of America where I was growing up, the Boy Scout will go to a summer camp, which is a week-long camp, and the idea is they go there to earn a lot of merit badges all at once to sort of gain rank. So the story takes place over the course of 1 week, the seven chapters for every day of the week. So it's about this group of kids and the ways in which they interact, and it's very much about how horrible and difficult it is being a teenage boy, sort of jockeying for power, constantly, you know, picking on one another, teasing. But there's also, in contrast, there are grown-ups at the camp. One of them is a first-time dad. He's never been to the Boy Scout camp before. And there's similar dynamics happening amongst the grown-ups, from the very sort of aggressive alpha troop leader to this dad who's much more meek and uncomfortable in social situations. Another dad. So the two sets of male relationships are sort of contrasted. A lot of the plot has to basically do with, you know, three of the kids bring LSD with them to the camp, which they do while they're there. They get into trouble. They get into trouble in a lot of other ways. And it's about, like, actually has a lot to do with what the Boy Scouts as an institution ends up disciplining and what they don't. And they end up spending a lot of time disciplining kids for things that are maybe not important, and ignoring the fact that they're treating each other badly and how they interact, which is what they really should be trying to focus on. So it's a little bit of a criticism. The book is, I call it fiction. It is fiction. It's made up characters, but a lot of the events are based around my own life. I was a teenager in the 1990s, living in New York, New Jersey area where it takes place. A lot of the characters, and even some of the dads, they're modeled on people I knew or combinations of people I knew. I find that's just sort of, you know, there's a lot of memories and anecdotes that happen in reality that were fun to put into the book. The drawing in this book is purposefully, for me, pared down, clean, and with an emphasis on body language and facial expressions, because so much of the story has to do with just how these boys are interacting, especially since, in theory, they're friends with each other. But even in friendships, there's dynamics, and there are boys who are really sort of leading things, and there are boys who are getting dragged along, just hoping not to be the ones who get singled out and picked on. Sometimes I work a little bit more dense, and I work in a more busy style. But since this story was set in the woods, I also wanted to give it a sort of a clean openness. I wanted it, and one thing I thought in my head as I went through the book, I was thinking about how people read comics very rapidly. And so very much with this book, I thought I would do something where I would just draw most of the pages very quickly, keep it clean and light, and then just every now and then remind people that I know how to draw and do a really lush establishing setting, something that shows the environment. Because I think as you read a comic, many times the background can just fade out of your mind because you're just caught up in the action. So that was sort of my approach to drawing in this one in particular. Trying to think of if there were any particular scenes, especially when the boys are fighting. Towards the end, when it finally all breaks loose, and they are actually having physical like hitting and stuff like that, I had a lot of fun staging the action of the boys pulling and tugging at each other. I don't know if you've ever seen real life fights. In real life, when people fight, it's always the ugliest, messiest thing. Like, people just, the shirt's getting pulled, and, like, you know, it's all stretched out of the neck, and, you know, it's not like in action movies where somebody just gets punched and goes down. It's crying, and, you know, and I had a lot of fun just the acting, the sort of acting through the drawings.